Hello everyone and welcome back to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. It is Francesco here. Welcome to another video. In today's video, we are discussing my Evernote 2019 wish list. I'm going to be sharing with you guys some of my features that I'd like to see next year, as well as general things that Evernote should release. In my opinion, I've got a few notes in front of me. I'm also going to be discussing the chat that I had with Evernote CEO Ian Small and sharing a few insights that he was able to share with me in our conversation. So guys, in today's video, I'd love to hear your opinions about Evernote, what your wish list would be. So pop them in the comments below, as well as comment on what you think about my thoughts on the wish list. So guys, let's run the introduction. That was quite a good click, like a 9 out of 10 click there. So guys, today's video is sponsored by Sanebox. A big thank you to Sanebox for sponsoring this full week here on the Keep Productive YouTube channel. Let's just run a short ad that I made for Sanebox about how I use it, a little bit of an insight. So let's run that advertisement. So this month's sponsor is Sanebox. For those who don't know, Sanebox is an email management tool that helps you to take back control of your email. For those who use Google, Office 365, iCloud, Yahoo, or any other email service that feel a little overwhelmed, it's definitely worth exploring Sanebox. As a user and subscriber myself, Sanebox helps to keep my email clean in a range of very smart ways. Here's three that particularly help me. The first is Sane Later. This is a folder dedicated to reducing the amount of interruptions and distractions you get across your day. So it'll filter less important emails into this area for later. The next is Sane News. Now Sane News is a folder dedicated to newsletters and mailing lists. I can check back in at the end of my day and find all of the useful mailing lists I subscribe to, but during the day it doesn't interrupt me. And finally, Sane No Reply, and I can check in on any email who needs a reply or a nudge. The best thing is that Sanebox allows you to train each of your emails in your account. Ideal if you're looking to feel calmer about what's coming in as it comes in. Those are just a few of my personal favorites. As a little thank you for being subscribers here on Keep Productive, you can start a free trial with $25 credit using the link below. Thanks again to Sanebox for sponsoring this week here on the Keep Productive YouTube channel. So guys, naturally I discussed a few weeks ago about how I use Evernote on a daily basis. I still use it for functional things like financial information, election information, medical information, house information, things like that, like PDFs and data that I wanted to secure inside of Evernote. And I still find it a useful resource for search, being able to go back and find the information that I need to collect out of it. Now, in terms of my wish list, I have it here in front of me, and I want to go through some 5 key things that I'd like to see in Evernote next year. So the first thing on that list for me is the interactive elements. I'd like to see more table abilities inside of Evernote, as well as some viewing functionality. Inside of applications like Notion, the thing that is leading the way is the interactive element side. Notion delivers these amazing boards and these amazing tables, calendars as well, although it does lack them, and also they've added gallery and list in the last month. So I do believe Evernote can really benefit from having much more interactive tables and elements inside of their page. This would allow users to be a bit more able to plan and visualize things as they come up. Now, I'm not talking about really advanced stuff here. Maybe those applications do a better job of them because Evernote is more of a note-taking experience, but I would like to see something like this. They did a lot of work to tables last year, but I believe it wasn't as progressive as the likes of other apps like Notion and Coda. And another interactive element that I'd like to see is the dashboards element. Obviously, Evernote last year, I believe it was released Spaces, which was an attempt at dashboards, and essentially you can only get that on the business account right now, but they are planning to release it to personal. But I don't think that's quite it. I think that there almost needs to be this page where you need to plan and plot out links and shortcuts to notes and almost organize a homepage for you around your Evernote account. I'm not sure exactly how this could be done because it'd be quite tricky to do, but in essence, I think it would massively help the Evernote users out there. So relationships, I'm not sure why I titled it relationships. So I would like to see in 2019, the ability for Evernote to connect up with notes. Now, a few years ago, they released a feature called Context, which a lot of you guys know already, but I do think they could go a lot further with this. I'd like to see, for example, if I opened up like a bit of medical information or something like that, inside of the note to have recommended or related notes that would be relevant to that, or that would help me to get that done. So for example, let's say I was planning out a trip to Italy with my family. I would, for example, might want to know some of my banking information or some relevant information about things I've clipped in the past. So context doesn't quite do that for me. I'd like to see something more machine learning based inside of Evernote that would help recommend notes inside of notes and help you get things done as well. So hopefully they do something to do with this in the next year. I'd also like to see better relationships between notes. So something that Coda does really well is the table functionality. If you create a table inside of Coda and you link it to another table or another page inside of Coda, you can actually have a table that is based on relationship. So for example, if you update that table, the other table gets updated too. I'd like to see that available inside of Evernote, as that would make Evernote tables more relatable and easier to use across the board. Especially if you and your team were planning something in one of your notes and you had a table and you updated it with all the stuff, and then you don't have to duplicate it or lose any data, you can make it a live table in the other views. That's something I don't think is currently available inside of Evernote. So in 2019, I'd also like to see updated pricing set up. So one thing that I noticed from as a user myself is the 10 gigabytes in premium. At the moment, they only have free and premium, which is a bit of a shame. They only have premium at 10 gigabytes, which I think, in my own opinion, is way too much storage for me, even if I went on that plan. I'd like to see something that allows you to pay up to your storage amounts per month. I'm not sure how that would work, but that would be very useful. I know that they are looking, I know that at the moment they're A/B testing the plus package, which is the medium ground. I believe that was like, was it 2 gigabytes, something like that? There was like a middle ground storage limit. You get 60 megabytes in the free version, but I would really like to see the plus version back again, because if it were up to me, I'd probably go for that middle pricing. Although at the moment, I'm comfortable with free. So number four is automation. I'd like to see more abilities in automation. Coda this week released brand new automation abilities, allowing you to press a button inside of Coda that you create, and it essentially allows you to react with other applications. Now, Notion is bringing this to the table in API world next year. Probably, that's my prediction. But I do think that something like this in Evernote would work massively. Evernote has so many integrations, and if you had an integration, for example, like they released with Microsoft Teams, that would be amazing. So for example, you complete a Evernote project, or you're working on a project, and you'd like to pass it to someone else. A quick press of a button, and it nudges someone on Slack or on Microsoft Teams about that, that would be fantastic. So I think buttons inside of Evernote would be a fantastic move and a head towards automation inside of Evernote. So moving on to security, I'm not sure I'm fully aware of this, but I don't think Evernote has Touch ID security. I'm not sure, but I can't seem to find it on my settings area. Please correct me in the comments if I'm wrong. If that is the case, I'd like to see them do Touch ID. I'd also like to see them, and a lot of people would like notebook level security as well as note security too. That's lock on side of your notes, because that would be great, an ability to be a bit more specific about how you secure your notes. I know this is something that is happening inside of Slack Enterprise. They do a great job at being able to secure what specific people or new onboards can actually see inside of Slack. So maybe they could do something like this with Evernote. So those were my five recommendations. I'm going to talk a little bit about community now in terms of like where I would like to see it go. I had an opportunity to chat with Charlotte before my call with Ian, which was really great. And Charlotte's always like an open book with the Evernote community side of stuff. So that's fantastic. And that's so good to hear. So it you know, as you can imagine, I shared my thoughts with her. But this is how I'd like to see the community develop over time. I would love to see more case study videos in terms of you guys as Evernote premium users using Evernote on a daily basis. I'd love to see how you set up things, how you go about tackling work and life challenges with it. I think one of my favorite videos on the channel when it first came out, the Evernote channel, is the Evernote for Life, or was it called Evernote's Life's Work video. Fantastic video about how different people in work and life used Evernote on a daily basis. And it even had Tim Ferriss in it. It was a really good video. But I always used to, and I'm just being honest here, I used to open it up and sometimes just watch it to get inspiration. Like when I was a lot younger and using Evernote, I was like, this is such a great video to inspire new people to jump on Evernote or to expand your knowledge of Evernote, even though it was so, even though it didn't even include like all the product side of stuff. I also think there as well, there could be some great interviews and some great collaborations with Evernote premium users and those who use Evernote on a daily basis for lots of different scenarios. I think I'd like to see what the community is using it for right now. So next up is, so just one final thing there is, I did mention my chat with Ian Small, the CEO of Evernote. I did post on the Keep Productive group a little bit about it, but I guess I haven't shared it with you guys yet. I would say the chat went very well. I think Ian is a really nice chap, like person. I think I think what I learned from that talk as well is he seems to be a good storyteller as well, which is quite nice. Ian, for example, I was watching Rogue One before the call and I decided to pause it and do the call and then go back to it. And we got in a little bit of a side chat about Star Wars and it was quite nice the story he told about how he watched episode 5 when he was 14 or 15 and he went to the cinema to watch it and he was telling me that story and it was a really good story. But I love how that could be, his storytelling ability could be part of Evernote's journey. Now, overall, the chat went well. I think he is super keen. He is listening to all of you guys out there. And it sounds like he's listening to all formats, all stakeholders in terms of their opinion on Evernote, how Evernote's done wrong in the past, but learning from those mistakes versus using that as a sort of marker, I guess. So I'm quite excited for what Evernote brings to the table in 2019. I doubt we'll see anything for a fair few weeks because Ian has to get enrolled and learn from the internal and external side of stuff. So that's gonna be quite exciting, but you know, let's call back in a couple of months to see how Evernote are doing. So in terms of leapfrogging, I think if in 2019, I think if Evernote did something with AI and machine learning and introduced a interactive modular productivity software that Notion has and combines the two, I think that could be a good leapfrog forward. I think a lot of people have a space in their heart for Evernote, and me particular, like it was the first productivity application I came across, and I fell in love with everything about it, like from the stickers to the CEO to the notebooks to the actual product itself. And I think that they can actually get back to that state. And if they do, like if they do catch up or leapfrog these applications, I think a lot of people will move back over because they'll have that sense of trust and love for Evernote that they might not necessarily have built up in the period of time with these companies. So I think one of the things that Evernote does really well is it's for everyone, like everyone from creatives to professionals. They do a great job at marketing it out to all audiences, all ages, all types of work situations. So I think they do a good job at that. But one thing I think that in 2019 they shouldn't focus too much on is being worried about feature overload. This is something that in the past they got a lot worried on. They fixed the problem because they've improved the onboarding. So when a new user signs up, at least there's some insight into how to use Evernote. Whereas in the past there really wasn't. You had to be a pro, you onboard and you were like flustered with the amount of features there are. But I do think they should not worry too much about that. They fix the onboarding. I think now is a time to just start adding features and start getting robust in terms of what Evernote is structurally and what people think it is. So guys, hopefully you enjoyed this insight into Evernote 2019 predictions almost, or wish list. It'd be great to hear some of your opinions in the comments. If you enjoyed this video, hit the like button below. And if you are brand new to Keep Productive, please do subscribe because we do videos like this as well as tons more. And it'd be great to have you as a community member. Anyway guys, a big thank you for stopping by today. I really hope that you enjoy the week ahead. I hope that you enjoy all the videos here this week on the Keep Productive. Anyway guys, a little thank you to Sanebox for sponsoring this week here on Keep Productive. But without further ado, I will see you guys very, very soon. Make sure to have a great week, keep productive, and I'll see you guys very, very soon. Cheers.